What's up, everybody? Oh, God, it's been some time since I've done some side work at home. Let me tell you what. But no, for real. I haven't been doing any side work for work at home for a long time. It's actually been pretty nice. Today, I'm going to be doing a downpipe on a Golf R. I haven't made a video how to do one, I don't think. But I'm going to do this one. Not sure how much is going to correlate to people that don't have a lift, that just have the ground, just a jack or whatever, but I think, I don't know, I'll do it my way and then it'll help people out with theirs. For now, I'm just going to rack the car, trying to cool it down with the fan. So the first thing I like to do is take the 13s off for the downpipe that come in through this way. So they're right over here, right below where it's hot as hell. These two 13s that have to come off. So I'm gonna go up all the way because I can still barely touch this thing, it's so hot. I'm going to take the shield off the right there. Wait, where is it? Oh, those right there. That shield that covers the axle, I'm going to take that off. I like to come in through here with a ball Allen, a super long extension thingy. I'll show you here in a second. Trying to find where to clamp this thing. Oh, I can't clamp it there. Let's see if I can get it up in here. Got it. Not really. But it's gonna be this shield right here. It kinda gets in the way. So maybe it's just let's do a tripod, huh? Right here, so I come in through here and then I just get in with the ball Allen here. And then you can get it loose and get it off. underneath here. This thing. Next, you're gonna pull off this 16 right here. Triple square off up here. Where is it? Right there. I'll highlight it in the video. So you want to get this shield out of the way. Now you want to take the drive shaft bolts off. There's three of them. So there's one, and then that's a 10 millimeter 12 point. Really helps you have an impact gun on this. I don't even think my electric one's strong enough. Give it a try. That's a 9 though. That's a 9. Then it's gonna use an air. But if you grab both your wheels, you can spin the axle. make sure you're spinning them the right way. Three of those holding it on, and then I take the dog bone off. Also, just allows you to swing the engine to move the drive shaft out of the way. So you gotta push the drive shaft to the side. Now it's over to the side, out of your way. And then now I'm going to take the 13 mils off from the top. The 213 millimeters. Still pretty hot, so this kind of sucks. To undo your oxygen sensor too. Black one. It's already a great one. Not getting easier as I go. I gave up on the 13mm right now, and I'm trying to get the O2 sensor off. It's kind of in my way. Son of a bitch, I thought. I highly suggest running to Harbor Freight or whatever and getting an O2 sensor socket. Makes things a lot easier. Warming up out here. I had a tough time getting this one off, so I'm going back on with it to make sure it didn't. Doesn't strip on the way out, get caught, break. especially the golf R's, is before you tighten anything up, like fully, before you think you're done, just make sure you got all the clearance that you need. So like, you have to, if you can twist this, you know, make sure you twist it to where it's out of the way. See how it's hitting the body now? There, so you want to make sure that you got like the perfect angle. Because once you tighten these down, it's a real bitch to move. So you don't get much clearance here. Eek, stupid thing. So just make sure everything's good where you want it before you start tightening things down. So everything looks pretty good here. As far as alignment, and so I'm just gonna go ahead and start putting it back together now. Thank you. So I got this on. Didn't air my compressor for that. Got the pendulum mount back on. I haven't started the 13s, I'm just gonna do those from the top. This is currently upside down, so I'm gonna have to flip that around when I'm done. Get the back on. Just give it a good shake. Make sure that it's not hitting anything. Because once you start driving, if it's touching or it's close now, it's gonna touch when you're driving. Yeah, I'm throwing the axle shield back on, tighten the V-band, and then be done with it. Really, going together is the easiest part. Coming down with this stupid big downpipe is the hardest thing. So after you get the new one on, you should have like no gap, or a little tiny gap. If you have a giant gap here, and it's pretty tight, then you probably didn't seat it properly on the turbo. So I would take it back off and then make sure it's on there. Because once you slide the downpipe into the turbo, you should be able just to squeeze the V-band like almost all the way together. And then you know it's seated all the way. So you gotta make sure your downpipe's all the way in the turbo.